Welcome back, ladies and gents. Today, we're on ScreenRant.com. Normally not a very accurate source of information, but I found this article a bit interesting. We're going to talk about Mandalorian tonight on episode 127 of the show, but I wanted to touch on this article, given the subject of it is a cast member of my, well, one of my favorite television shows of all time, Lost.
Do you have any idea how badly I want to kill you?
I'm speaking of Titus Welliver. The Mandalorian, why the Imperial Captain was so ready to destroy the ship. The Mandalorian Season 2, Episode 3 saw Imperial Captain Titus Welliver take drastic action, attempting to crash his ship and kill all aboard. So, The Mandalorian Season 2, Episode 3 saw an Imperial Captain played by Bosch star Titus Welliver ready to take drastic action to deny the Mandalorians his ship by crashing it instead of allowing it to be captured. Set 5 years after the events of Return of the Jedi, The Mandalorian takes place in a galaxy where the Empire is in full retreat. In fact, officially the Empire and the New Republic have signed a treaty called the Galactic Concordance, but it's becoming clear there are still some Imperial holdout. Of course, we realize that the article goes on here to talk about Moff Gideon, played by Giancarlo Esposito. He's in possession of the Darksaber, which Bo-Katan Kryze is looking for. Yes, that's Katie Sackhoff's character. And anybody familiar to geekdom, Katie Sackhoff is a goddess. She is, Gina Carano is kind of getting to those lines now, those ranks, with her portrayal of Cara Dune and her refusal to back down from the Twitter mob. Something that Katie Sackhoff has not faced, but we're going to talk about that coming from another woman, actually, bagging on Katie Sackhoff and Sasha Banks. Not them personally, but their armor. So it says one such holdout appears to have been in the area around Luke Skywalker's homeworld Tatooine. That's, of course, Moff Gideon. And it says the New Republic Defense Fleet has increased patrols in this sector, having reported increased Imperial activity. All signs of this part of the galaxy is about to explode into war once again. The Mandalorians are set to be in the thick of it, with Bo-Katan leading raids on Imperial vessels. In The Mandalorian Season 2, Episode 3, she went so far as to attempt to capture a freighter, and Moff Gideon commanded the captain to go to drastic lengths to deny her this prize. Captain Welliver shot the rest of his crew before trying to crash his ship. Then he committed suicide rather than being captured and interrogated. So you can see here, this is just a absolute dominance that Gideon has over these officers that are so loyal to the Empire at this point. It goes on to say in the article, it's now important to understand that the Empire has been reduced to its most loyal, amoral, and extreme leaders. It is one thing to rule through the threat of fire, but it's another thing to act in such a way that you earn that fear, and the destruction of Alderaan shocked people across the galaxy. After the events of Return of the Jedi, Palpatine's sentinel droids issued orders to initiate a scorched earth policy called Operation Cinder. Operation Cinder forced every remaining Imperial to decide whether to obey the Emperor no matter what, even when fighting a losing battle. As a captain in the Empire, Titus Welliver will have actively participated in Operation Cinder, committing unknown atrocities. He was a fanatic. So you can see why his actions were so drastic. When his, and you could tell the two pilots of the ship, they kind of gave each other that look, like after the conversation with Moff Gideon, they knew it was coming. They knew their time was up. And he shot them both without hesitation, prepared to nosedive the ship and kill anybody and everybody below them, just for the sake of not letting the Mandalorians have the weaponry on the ship. So my final thoughts on this character played by Titus Welliver, and the relation to how he fits into the Imperial mold in the attempted rebuilding of the Empire and that reformation under Moff Gideon. I think, like I said, this man rules, speaking of Moff Gideon, with an iron fist, and he's instilled that fear into the remaining remnants of the Empire that are under his leadership. We know the Empire kind of split into like warlords and such post Return of the Jedi. But no, I like this. I like Titus Welliver's character. I really like him as a heel. I was great as the Man in Black and Lost, but I thought this brief role for him, this cameo, fit really well. And he was perfect in it as a member of that Imperial machine, just a cog in the wheel. It's like, okay, so this is going to fall into the Mandalorian's hands, these weapons. Let's destroy them. Let's destroy them and get rid of them so they don't get them. What do you guys think? Let me know in the comments below. Are you digging the Mandalorian? You know, season two right now. Do you like the inclusion of Bo-Katan in this? Especially played by Katie Sackhoff, who voiced the character in the Clone Wars. I can't speak to Rebels because, like I said, I've seen bits and pieces of episodes of Rebels. I've never sat down and watched a full episode, so I really can't speak to that. But what I have seen in the Clone Wars, I've always dug. Got some to finish, but I'm liking The Mandalorian right now. Damn, I like Sasha Banks. Not gonna lie, I hate her in the wrestling ring, but don't mind seeing her in this. And it was just kind of cool to see some different perspective from the Mandalorians. Let me know what you guys think in the comments below. Do all the YouTube things. Like, share, subscribe, but do it the way we do. Bitch slap that like button. Click that subscribe. Let's go from there. Let's take it home. Remember, I'm Etepo Kuhn of The Place to Be Reviews. Been here with all of you. If you want to hear more Mandalorian talk, tune in tonight. Episode 127 of the podcast, live right here on the channel, or catch the playback. I've been here with all of you. And remember, if I don't see you, have a great day and a pleasant tomorrow. I'll catch you on the next one.